The 1960s were a time of enormous civil unrest. Demonstrations, face-offs, and riots characterized the political climate as the nation coiled in tension. In California, a man named Cesar Chavez led a strike of migrant farm workers demanding higher wages and better working conditions. The strike was part of the civil rights movement that addressed the needs of farm workers. It was a turning point in America's history. He envisioned equality and social change, not just for farm workers, but for all people. A leader of people who didn't have a voice. He would grow to become one of the most respected civil rights leaders of the 20th century. Born in 1927 Arizona, Cesar Estrada Chavez, as with many other Mexican Americans, was absorbed into the migrant worker lifestyle when his family lost their farm during the Great Depression. They moved to California in search of opportunity, but found only misfortune. He grew up impoverished and completed only 8 grades of school. In the late 1940s, after serving in the Navy, he married Helen Fabella and settled in Delano, California to start their family. After meeting Fred Ross, he worked his way from being a farm worker to being a farm labor organizer with Ross's community service organization. There, he registered voters, gave citizenship classes, and began to develop his vision for a struggle toward social change. In 1962, that vision for equality and social change manifested in the National Farm Workers Association. Along with the help of Dolores Huerta, it eventually became the United Farm Workers. He used this platform and his unparalleled leadership to expose to the American people the inhumane conditions and unfair wages that were imposed upon the farm workers. He fought for the farm workers' right to form their own union, which most other workers in the United States were privileged to have. He demanded that the workers have lunch breaks, access to clean drinking water and bathrooms, and that they receive fair wages and were able to collect unemployment insurance.
Workers are not working. They should have the right, as any other worker in America has today, to go to the Department of Employment and get a weekly compensation check so they can live and live in not only decency, but also be able to live with themselves, be able to live with their families, and not have to depend on a handout or charity.
When the workers went on strike in 1965, police violence against the farm workers resulted in severe beatings. When one worker was beaten to death, Chavez called off the strike. He, like his contemporary Martin Luther King Jr., remained steadfast in his decision to practice nonviolent protest. Not a single time did they ever retaliate.
The farm workers, that they've been able to hold back and to continue to espouse the whole idea of nonviolence.
In 1968, Chavez fasted for a historic 25 days, bringing a national attention back to the movement and injecting much-needed hope and motivation into his supporters. Mass media coverage of his initial boycott of table grapes would increase the national awareness and add more pressure to the growers of the farms by humiliating them. Finally, after years of striking in 1970, the UFW won a victory for the labor movement as the growers accepted union contracts and guaranteed the workers higher wages and improved working conditions.
We'll turn around the boycott machines all over the world to try and make grapes, all the grapes, sweet grapes again.
Chavez's success inspired the emergence of new civil rights leaders such as Reyes López Tierrino and Rodolfo Corky González. Their contributions expanded Chavez's vision of social justice. Not only did he improve workers' rights, but rights for all people in the United States, forever changing the face of America. He also championed the preservation of the environment by fighting against the irresponsible use of pesticides. He continued to fight alongside farm workers, marching and fasting many times, until his death in 1993. year after his death in 1994, President Bill Clinton posthumously awarded him the Presidential Medal of Freedom. His wife Helen was there to accept the honor.
Workers who labored in the fields and yearned for respect and self-sufficiency pinned their hopes on this remarkable man who, with faith and discipline, with soft smoke and humility, and amazing inner strength, led a very courageous life.
In many places around the country, his legacy is honored in street names, in parks, in schools, and in libraries. His birthday has become a holiday in several states. Now, he is the first Latino to have his memory solidified forever in a monument on a major university campus.